Hi, and welcome to the Interaxis YouTube channel and interaxis.io. Today we're going to move forward talking more about fund management, and in this video we're going to talk specifically about the Melon Protocol. Now, Melon Protocol was developed in Switzerland, and here's what it is. It's a system looking at fund management, so managing some sort of mutual fund, hedge fund, investment fund. And what they're trying to attack is the ability to make it easier, the administration easier. So if you remember from a previous video, we talked about fund management and everything that has to go in it. So if I decide I want to invest, put my money into some sort of fund and have a manager manage it because they can do it better than I can do it on my own. That's the point, and I'm willing to pay them a fee. Well, part of that fund management is they have to acquire clients, right? They have to acquire clients or investors, right? They also have to distribute, which means they have to find maybe advisors, like I'm an advisor, and say, Adam, we want you to bring your clients in, right? Within that, they also have to manage the fund, which means they have to trade equities, debt, crypto, whatever it is. They have to trade it and manage the fund. Then what they also have to do is they have to track all their investors, right? They have to know who all the investors are so that when these trades, when they pay dividends or when they pay income or when they make trades, it gets passed through to the investors' accounts. They also have to report, right? If I'm an investor or if I'm an advisor, I need reports on what's going on within the fund. There's also reporting that needs to be done from a regulatory perspective, right? There's reports and issues that have to be taken care of from a regulatory perspective, depending on what the jurisdiction is, whether it's the US or Europe or Asia or whatever it might be. There's different regulatory restrictions. So all of this costs quite a bit of money to try to, for a fund manager, a new fund manager, or any fund manager to try to build a fund and get investors, right? They have to kind of prove that they know what they're doing. Then they have to distribute and acquire clients, right? Which might mean things like road shows. It might mean going to different RIAs or different distributors or different custodians and saying, here's what I have, here's what I'm good at. Let me show you my pedigree. Let me show you everything I've done and why it might be good for your clients or your investors. Then they need to track. They need to be able to pay all the investors, either distributions or dividends or whatever it might be. They need to be able to report. So I, as the investor, need to get reports, but those reports might also have to be go through to my custodial platform or go through to whatever reporting tool I use. So they have to be able to build that, and there's regulatory issues. And what all this does is it means that it's expensive. Right, it is expensive, it is time-consuming, everything, to be a fund manager, to try to start a fund. So there are a lot of really good, probably talented, potential fund managers out there in the world that aren't able to do it because they might not have access to the people with money. They might not have access to the investors. They might not have access to the advisors, right? And it's not worth it for them to put their money in to try to build up a fund and build up a following, so they just don't do it, right? They're not going to have access. So what Melon has done is they have a history of fund management, and they've said, look, we're going to package all this up and put it in one kind of neat, easy to design package. This is all going to be in one because, again, we're in the decentralized world. So you should be able to do things like trading in a decentralized fashion. It's relatively transparent. So reporting should be kind of easy in the decentralized world, right? It's transparent. You can just plug in some code and grab all the reporting requirements, grab the history, grab the income, grab the trades, etc. You should be able to track your investors. We should be able to tokenize things, and it should be just as transparent and easy as the reporting. The regulatory requirements the same, right? If all the data is out there on a blockchain, we should just be able to grab it. And then the distribution and the acquiring clients, well, part of that is if I don't have to spend money on all this necessarily, I can put my money more towards acquiring clients and distribution. But eventually there should be some sort of digital distribution anyway, right? It should be relatively simple for me as an advisor to look at the track record and the ability of this particular fund and go, oh, well, I definitely want my clients in that. It's relatively transparent. It's potentially decentralized. I can see what they've done in the past. I can see what their performance is up to the minute. And so, yeah, I'm going to put my clients' money in that because it's very easy to track and see, and it's transparent. And that makes acquiring clients a lot easier. And they don't necessarily have to acquire clients worth hundreds of millions of dollars to make their fund go and to prove themselves. They might be able to start with a much smaller amount because they're not having to put all these expenses out. So it goes from expensive to inexpensive and less time. So again, the important thing is, as we're doing with all these decentralized applications and the whole DeFi space, right, which we keep harping on, lower fees, lower friction. Lower fees and lower friction means more participants. More participants from the investor side, because I'm going to feel more comfortable and I'm going to be able to find these fund managers. More participation from the fund management side. That if there's a really good young fund manager, maybe they use algorithmic trading. Maybe they just identified something in the market. Maybe they've got some new sort of hedge fund or something. They're going to be able to bring a fund out without having to raise hundreds of millions of dollars and prove themselves. And maybe they can bring 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 funds out because they just keep using this platform. And maybe they just tweak this part, and the rest of the platform kind of remains the same. And they can throw 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 funds out there for different risk profiles and be able to do that relatively inexpensively. And they can do it essentially from anywhere in the world. Right, they don't have to be in New York or San Francisco or London or Switzerland to launch this fund. They could essentially be anywhere. So that's what Melon Protocol is trying to do. Now, they're admittedly having some issues, mainly in the regulatory sphere, but they've done a great thing, right? They've taken their own time and their own money to build out all of this to make it easier in the future for fund managers to be able to launch, manage, and grow their funds. So we're going to be seeing a lot of cool things from Melon Protocol. They recently created their own structure called Avant-Garde Finance, where they're going to try to, I believe, launch some of their own funds using their own protocol. So they're you know, kind of practicing what they preach, eating their own food, whatever metaphor you want to use, whatever cliche, that's what they're starting to do. So check out Melon Protocol. I will put links to their protocol in the notes here on the video. Avant-Garde Finance, I'll put some links to that, their blog and such, but this is going to be really interesting. It's really important because what we're seeing is, again, more participation, more fund managers are going to be able to launch and grow funds, more investors are going to be able to get involved. It's really important. So don't forget to subscribe to the YouTube channel. Find us at interaxis.io on the web, or hit us on Twitter at interaxis8, the number 8. Let us know if you like these videos and let us know if there are any others you want to see.